So in the today's session, what we will do, I mean yesterday what we covered is the first part and this test type. Now what we will cover is test level. This is what we will try, and then the maintenance testing. So these two topics we will try to cover, and they are also not interrelated to the previous two topics. So now coming to test levels, so let's see the overview of it. Okay. So again, if you see, it is of type K2 because we have different levels, and at all the levels what we need to do is we have to do the comparison between the test level objectives. So what is the objective of component testing and how it is different from the integration testing or from the system testing or from the acceptance testing. So this differentiation should be clear. So that's why it is K2. Question will be direct, but you should know the objective of each level clearly. Similarly, what are the type of documents we need as a requirement? So this requirement document will also be, you should know for which level, what type of requirement you need. What type of test object? So test object is the object which is under test, which you want to test. So for component testing, what you will get for test? For integration testing, what you will get for test? So that is what it is. Typical defects and failures. So at all the levels, what type of defect do you find or what type of failure you can get? And what are the different type of approaches and responsibilities? So who is responsible for which level? So all these things we have to compare in this test level, for the test level. And that is why we have K2. So it's a little bit big topic, but a simple one. So I will try to make it as simple as possible. So first of all, what is test level? Test levels are groups of test activities that are organized and managed together. So this is group of test activity which are organized and managed together. So we will, in the each test level, we will have some activities, and those activities are organized and managed together. So initially what we will have here is, 1 minute. So first we will have test process. So this is the higher level where we will have the process, like how to do testing and what are the different levels we will have, like planning and all those stuff. Planning, control and coordination, analysis, design, implementation, execution, completion. So those activities, that is the process. Then comes the test levels. Okay, so you can do planning and all those things for component testing also. You can do it for integration testing or at any other level of testing. So first will be the process, then comes the test level. And inside test level, you will have certain activities. For component testing, your activities will be different. For system testing, your activities will be different. Okay. Now, since we know this, the important point is, for every test level, a suitable test environment is required. And the same test level, I mean, we can keep the same test level also if it is possible for all testing, but that is not advisable, right? So because for component testing, the environment could be less costly compared to the system testing environment. Okay, so that's why at every test level, a suitable test environment is required. So again, remember, first we have a test process. Out of that, we have the test levels. And then for each test level, we will have different activities. That is the reason we need a suitable test environment for that. So what are the different environments? So first level is the component level. So this is the initial. So as soon as the code is ready, we can perform component testing on that piece of code or module. Then comes the integration testing. So once two or three components are ready, we can start the integration testing. Then comes the system testing. So once all the modules are ready, we have the software and we can perform the system testing on it. And then finally, we have acceptance testing. So once we complete our testing, we give it to the customer or user for the usage. Now, as we also saw, for each test level, we should have a different test environment. So normally, in normal cases, component testing and integration testing can be done at the developer's lab itself. So developer's environment, by the developer only it will be done. Whereas For the system testing and acceptance testing, we need the test environments. So दिस इज क्लियर राइट. कॉम्पोनेंट टेस्टिंग, इंटीग्रेशन सिस्टम एंड एक्सेप्टेंस टेस्टिंग, द फर्स्ट टू लेवल कॉम्पोनेंट एंड इंटीग्रेशन टेस्टिंग आर डन एट डेवलपर सेटअप इटसेल्फ एंड दिस इज डन एट द फॉर दिस टू परफॉर्म वी नीड द टेस्ट एनवायरमेंट. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द ओवरव्यू ऑफ टेस्ट लेवल. नाउ वॉट वी नीड टू सी इज फॉर ईच टेस्ट लेवल, फॉर एग्जाम्पल फॉर कॉम्पोनेंट लेवल we need to see what is the objective of component testing. Similarly, next we will see what is the objective of integration testing and henceforth. Then what are the requirements which we need for that particular level? What type of test object we will get for testing? What type of defects we will find or what type of failures we will find? And finally, approaches and who are responsible for these levels. So first we will start with the definition. So we should know these levels clearly and then we will go with the differences, objectives and all. So component testing. Testing is performed on each individual component separately without integrating with other components. So here we will take the component separately when it is not integrated, or even if it is integrated, then we have to consider it as a separate component and then perform the testing on it. For an example, suppose this is the doubt. Any doubt? Okay, I thought there is some doubt. I think this is clear. If not, no problem. Then we will see an example to clarify the doubts. We already saw this example previously also. Like there is a, if the speed of the motor is more than 15 km per hour. So oh no, this is the new example. I'm sorry. So suppose there is a motor, if its speed is more than 150 km and temperature value is greater than 120 degree. So there is two things, the motor, the speed of the motor and the temperature. If speed is more than 150 degree or if the temperature is more than 120 degree, then switch off the motor. So these are the two conditions to switch off a motor, switch off a motor. So for that we can, someone can write a code like this. This is just for an example. For example, they have three functions. For in one function, what they are doing is they are just getting the data of the speed. Okay, they are getting the motor speed, they are updating it. This data they are sending it to the other module, and based on, and in this module what they are doing is they are reading the value of the temperature, and finally they are getting both of the data here, and they are based on the formula they are stopping the motor. So this is one complete code for this product or for this requirement. Now we can see that there are three different components. So this can be considered as component A, the first part. This one can be component B and this can be considered as component C. Now we have to perform individual testing on component A, B and C individually. Then it will be called as component testing. So for component testing we have three modules now here. Moving further, integration testing. When individual software modules are integrated logically and tested as a group. When they say logically, that means there should be some connection between those two modules. So at least some, we should pass something or we should take something or we should call some function from the other one, something like that. Somehow logically connected. It's not like that one module is nowhere related to the other module and we are trying to perform integration testing. Because in integration testing, what we will do is we will transfer the data. Let's see how. So same example, then we will have the same code. For this code, we already saw we will have the component. So initially what we will do, we will take two components. So we know that this component and this component are somehow interrelated because we get the value of speed from this functionality. So once this functionality will run, then only this will work. So in component testing, sorry, in integration testing, that is what we will see. So here we will update the value. We will see that this value is getting updated here and this particular variable is also updating or not based on the conditions here. So somehow we will pass the values here. Okay. Similarly, we can take another two component because here also we have this speed is coming to this one. So again, this is logically connected. At the end, what you need to remember is in integration testing, if we have the definition again, when individual software modules are integrated logically. So integration testing and the word integration will always come. Integrated, integration, like that you will get the words. Okay, so we already saw this. Now, Now we have, so we already saw integration testing. Integration testing means combining two modules, right? So we have two levels in this. So sometime they get into these details. So we have component integration testing and we have system integration testing. Okay, we have two levels in the integration testing: component integration testing and system integration testing. Now let's see a little bit more about them: component testing, integration testing, and system integration testing. Component integration testing, here interactions and interfaces between integrated components. So very simple, between two component, if we have a interaction or interfaces, it is a component testing. Quite simple. Similarly, interaction and interfaces between the system. So when we are in system testing, between the system packages, so if we are sending some data in some packages or some microservices. So microservices also helps in connecting to module or something like that. So these are also interfaces, somehow interfaces we can call them. So interactions and interfaces between system packages and microservices. Anyway, we will see them in more detail in our upcoming lecture. Now coming to the system testing. System testing is the test of a complete and fully integrated software product. Until and unless it is fully integrated, we can perform integration testing and we cannot perform system testing. So once the things are integrated completely, then the complete software is ready and then we can perform the system testing on it. When I say complete software, it does not mean that complete product, complete software for that release. We already saw this example and we saw that we have four components. When we are at system testing level, we don't care what is there. Okay? We just consider it as a system that there is a motor which is running, we have to stop it. What are our input? We have only two inputs. One is that the speed of the motor and the temperature of that motor. So speed and motor will be the input. And when we give it more than 51 and 21, what will happen? We should check the motor is stopping or not stopping. If it is stopping, fine, test case will pass. Not stopping, fail, test case will fail. So this is what we will consider. We will not care about what is written behind. Okay, so this is system testing. Now coming to the acceptance testing. Formal testing with respect to user need. So here also we perform the formal testing, but with respect to what? All three levels what we see previously, right? They are with respect to the specification. What is written in the specification? But when we come to component testing level, this is not with respect to the specification. This is with respect to the top level documents. For example, the expectations of the user, requirements, and business process. So I will give you one tip here. Whenever you see business, okay, any document which is related to business or any other term where business will be there, always relate it to acceptance testing. Okay, always the business term will be related to the acceptance testing. Why I am saying that? Because in the next slide onwards, you will see lots of these terms that we cannot by heart. But whenever you see business, at least that we can remember, it is related to acceptance testing. It's a high level document. To determine whether or not our system satisfies the acceptance criteria and to enable the user, customer, or other authorized entity to determine whether or not to accept the system. So here the main target is not to find the bug, just to see that whatever we are expecting, that is there or not. Only that much they are checking. They are not going deep and finding the bugs in the software. That is not the objective here. Whereas in all the other cases, in all the previous cases, the main task is to find the bug, as many bug as possible. But at this level, the bug should not be there. That is the expectation. In the previous level, we expect that more bug should come, but at this level, the expectation is different. We expect that the bug should not be there. Okay, with that we are performing this testing. Now there are different type of acceptance testing which is mentioned here, and they are also in detail afterwards. So first one is user acceptance testing, operational acceptance testing, contractual and regulatory acceptance testing, and last one is beta, alpha and beta testing. So most of the time we get question from here. Like you saw one question, no, previously, like what is the difference between confirmation testing and regression testing, and you got some three lines in each option. Similar type of questions we get in alpha and beta testing also. And answering these three questions are a little bit easy because with the term you can relate it. But here they will try to trick. We will see that. Again, remember these four test types are part of acceptance testing. User acceptance testing, operational acceptance testing. So how you can remember is like something related to user, something related to the business. Okay, the top level, it is always related to the acceptance testing. Then operational acceptance testing, contractual, regulatory related stuff. So what contract you made with the customer, are you fulfilling that or not? If there are any regulatory related requirements, government related requirements, that will also come under acceptance testing, alpha and beta testing. We will see about them in more detail afterwards, maybe tomorrow session. What you need to know now is the hierarchy. So this is the hierarchy which you know. One hierarchy I told you previously, the test process, that hierarchy you should know. Sometime you get question on that. Let first is test planning, then planning and control, analysis, design, implementation, execution and completion. That hierarchy. Next is this hierarchy in the second chapter. So first will come component testing, because you have components here. Initially you can get one or two component only. After that you can combine those components and you can perform integration testing. Then the twist is here. After system testing, we don't do system integration testing. We do system integration testing before system, because when we say system, the complete system is there. For example, when I say car, the car will be considered as a complete system. But the different service providers will be developing different products. Those all products will be combined and then we will perform one system testing on them. Okay, and after that it will system integration testing. We will integrate the system and then we will see that all the interactions are working fine or not. And at the end we will see that the complete system is working or not. So here we have the component testing, then component integration testing, system integration testing, system testing and acceptance testing. How they will ask question is, before system testing, which level comes? Okay, then they may give you some order. Like component testing, component integration testing, system integration testing, acceptance testing. So normally what we see, what normally people do, they think always integration testing comes afterwards, like component testing and component integration testing. And that is how they relate it here also. Okay, so it is not like that. Component integration testing is always done before the, sorry, system integration testing is done before the system testing. So this is the main point which you need to remember here. And component integration testing is quite simple where it is. So let's just summarize the points. So these are the definitions. So component testing, we check the individual components. Integration testing, we check the logically integrated components. System testing, we test the complete and fully integrated software. Acceptance testing, we consider the software, or we try to fulfill the expectation of the user. Here based on the business process or other things. Now we come to the first topic. So those whatever we studied, just to get an basic understanding of the test levels. Now what we will go in detail. So at each test level, what is the objective? So this should be clear now. Okay, so this is what same thing what I have explained in the first slide. So I will not say what it is here. So what are the typical objectives of testing? So this also we covered in first chapter, right? So this is the typical objective of testing, irrespective of the levels. We studied some seven here. Sorry. First one is to prevent defect. Obviously at each level we have to try that. Verify that the system requirement is fulfilled. At each level we have to do this also. To check whether the test object is complete, obviously we will check this also. We have to build the confidence. We have to find the defect. Failure, we have to provide information to the stakeholders, we have to comply to the contractual and regulatory requirements. So all these things we studied in first chapter, everything is applicable here. But right now we don't have to remember all these things. We should remember these things in first chapter only. Now we will go to the individual levels. Component testing, so we already know this is how in the example we saw it. First point is reducing risk. I don't think this is quite difficult. At all level we will have this, only until system level. So From here on, wherever from component testing, integration testing, system testing, you will see first point is reducing risk only, but not for the acceptance testing. Acceptance testing, we are not reducing the risk. So you have to remember this point very clearly. Second, you saw no, the normal objectives. So there also verify was there. Same thing. Verify whether the functional and non-functional behavior of the components are designed and specified. The whole sentence will remain same for all the levels, only this middle term will change. Component. So we have to verify the functional and the non-functional behavior of the components are designed and specified as expected or not. Next one, building the confidence in the component and the quality. Why we do testing? So to build the confidence. So, but where? In the component, because we are doing component testing. Finding defect. This is also nothing new. We find the defect where we are doing component testing. So component level. Preventing defects from escaping to the higher level. Obviously, we are doing all these things so that we find all the defects and it is not, it don't go to the next level. So these 5 points, if you remember, for all the test levels, you can easily get it. So first one is reducing the risk. Verifying whether functional and non-functional behavior of the components are designed as specified, building confidence in the component, finding defect in the component, and preventing defect from escaping to the higher levels. And now if I show you the integration testing, here you will not find anything new. Reducing risk. Verifying whether the functional and non-functional behavior of the interface, this is what will change, are as designed and specified. So interface related to integration testing. Building confidence in the quality of the interface. Finding defect. So where we have to find the defects? On the interfaces. Preventing defect from escaping to the higher level. So we do all this, we find all these things so that these defects are not, we don't find them in the system testing level. So then next level is system testing level. So none of the points were different, I guess. Moving further, again you will not find any differences here except from the term system. Reducing risk, same point. Verifying whether the functional and non-functional behavior of the system are as designed and specified. Building confidence in the quality of the system as a whole. Finding defects where in the system. Next, now this word is new here. Preventing defects from escaping to higher level or production. So if you see the word production, then it is related to system testing. Why? After you develop the thing, then it will go for production and then it will be produced and then will be given to the customer. If you are working for mobile or some product-based thing, so that will go for the production. So that's why we want to prevent defect to go to the production level. Okay, all the 5 points are same until three steps, three levels: component level, integration level, system level. If you just remember the outline, then all the points are same here, and except we have a production here. But when we go to and the last, sorry, the last point also, all the previous stages we were not validating, but here what we are doing is validating that the system is complete, because now the complete software is there. So now we can validate that system is complete and will work as expected. So this is what additional thing we have to do in system testing, and the same point will carry forward to the acceptance testing level, because there also we have the complete software, we can perform validation over there. But when you go to the acceptance level, this is also one more point. Now I will show you the difference. Let's first read this one. Establishing confidence in the quality of the system as a whole. So here this is the point where we have to establish the confidence. Now you may ask me, this is the same point we studied previously, but that's not the case. Where I am, one second. This is acceptance level. Yeah. So if you see the word here, this is building confidence. Slowly we are building the confidence. How? By finding the defects. Okay. But when we will build the confidence? When we don't find the defect when we test. That is what we do here. In the acceptance testing, when someone is performing the testing for this level, they should not find the defect. Then only they will say that we have established the confidence. but in the previous level on means in the previous levels we were building the confidence by finding the defects, and the objective is also to find the defect. Okay, so that is how we were building the confidence, but establishing the confidence will happen in acceptance level. So this, though the line almost looks the same, but if you get this line, this is meant for acceptance level testing. As I told, validating the system is as complete and will work as expected, because the complete software is there. We want to see it is working as expected. So then we will accept it. Then verifying that functional and non-functional behavior of the systems are specified. So not only the functional requirements, but they will also consider it from the non-functional behavior also. They will consider it at the acceptance level. It depends from project to project. So that is all about the different levels. So what I try to do is I just kept everything here, right? Just 1 minute. Where is my mouse? One minute. I have three screens, so I was just pointing my cursor over there. Okay. So if you see the first level, everywhere. Reducing risk, reducing risk, reducing risk. Next one, verifying whether functional and non-functional behavior of the component, of the interface, of the system. That's it. So you don't have to remember all the points for all the level. Next one, building the confidence everywhere, all three levels. Where? At the component level, at the interface level, at the system level. Finding defect in the components, finding defect in the interfaces. Here just finding defects in the system. Preventing defects to go to the other level. Here also the same. Here going to the other level. The other level is production level. Validating, the last point is the new one here. Validating that the system is complete and will work as expected. So these three, so remembering these three levels and the objective are not so difficult. What is next? And then the acceptance level. So this is a little different. So here we are establishing the constant, we confidence. We are not building the confidence, we are establishing the confidence. Validating that the system is complete and will work as expected. Same point, sixth point is, and second point here. And other than that, the only new and unique point over here is verifying that functional and non-functional behavior of the system are as expected. So with this, the objective ends, okay? I don't see that anything is difficult over here, even to remember or to buy heart. What I did is, 1 minute. Let me share it again. Is it visible to you again, the screen? Oh, I hope yes.
Thank you
for the feedback. Yeah, so what I did is I will just provide you a video afterwards. In that video, what will happen is one line will come. Okay, you can pause the video first, then you see that, or even if it is going on, you can see that reducing risk will come at what all levels. So you just have to say that, okay, these three levels it will come. See, acceptance level it is not coming, so you have to mark it, means you have to consider it. And then similarly for all the levels, like building confidence in the component or system. So where we build the confidence, it should come at all level. Right now I have removed it. I think it should, building confidence, right? Yeah, it should come at all levels. So means you can just do it once. Afterwards I will provide you this exercise. Similarly, some more points are there. So with respect to objects, you will get all the points. Just after this class you can go through it, and then this is done. You don't have to again read it. Now test level basis, test basis. Test basis means what? Requirements. What are the type of requirements we need? So objective we know. Now we see the requirements. When we are at the component testing level, we need the detailed design. Okay? I will not go through what is the detailed design. So I think this should be fine, that we need this detailed design, or you want to go through it. Software designer writes detailed design in order to give a software development team overall guidance to the architecture of the software project. So they will give you in the architecture level, they will do the design phase, and then the developer will see that this design, and then he will write his code, test case, sorry, his software. And the same document will be given to the tester also, so that he can see this detailed design and he can write his test cases. This is the actual procedure. Normally in company, people see the code and they write the test cases, which is wrong. Next is code. Code is also provided because you have to fetch this code, you have to execute this code. Then some data models. So if there are some values, some array is there, pointer is there, or any other variables are used, so what type of variable it is. So those type of data we will also get it here. At this level only we need it. And obviously we need the component specification. So for which requirement this code is written. So that also we need it. So we need four requirements here. One is the detailed design. It can also contain some flow charts or some design kind of stuff there. Sequential diagram, flow chart, like that. So detailed design. Then code. Then data model. So what type of data we are using. And then component specification. So when we are at component level, we need component specification. So these four documents we need it. Okay, so these are the four documents. Moving further, integration testing. So here we have to remember it, there is no other way. Software and system design. So we need the complete design, the software and system level design we need it, so that we know this one and this one are not logically connected, so not to perform integration testing on them, whereas this one is logically connected, so let's perform system integration testing on them, or which one to select first. We need to know that we need this software and system design to know the interfaces between which two module we have the interfaces. Okay, so that's why we need software and system design. Sequence diagrams. So what event will occur first, then what event will come, so like that some sequencing will be there in the code, maybe some if else statement. The flow chart also is one of the sequence diagram, how the data will flow. So like that system diagram. Then interface and communication protocol. So why we need communication? Obviously for the interfaces we want to communicate between two medium, so we need the communication. So if you just read the word related to integration testing. Interface anyways you will relate it, communication also you relate it to integration. Use cases. There was one question yesterday, what is the difference between Epic use cases. I didn't get a chance to see it, just now I remember. Tomorrow I will tell you, or I will just put it in the WhatsApp. Use cases. So if there is a feature, how it will be used by the user. Okay, so those use cases will be available here, so that we know the interactions. Basically we need all the documents in which the interactions are specified. And obviously we need the architecture at component or system level. So what is the architecture, from which level, where we are going, where in which different level the data is flowing. So these all things also we need it. So just by reading the terms, system and software and system design, sequence diagram, interface and communication protocol, use cases, architecture at component or system level, and last one is workflow. So workflow means if you just see the name, right, like the sequence diagram, we need the sequencing there, and then the workflow, and like the system design, the architecture. So they all somehow means the same, like where you will get the complete overview, like how the modules are connected with each other. And the external interfaces, external and internal interfaces. So how one module is connected with the other module internally, and how the complete software will be connected with the other modules. Anyways, the term interface is there, so just relate it to integration. Business, you have to relate it to acceptance testing, so don't forget that, and interfaces to the integration testing. So these are the points. We will go next. Now comes the system testing. This is quite clear. We need the SRS, software requirement specification, or system requirement specification. It could be functional and non-functional requirement. So we only already saw that this is the one of the requirement from the system requirement specification. Risk analysis report. Okay, so we studied in the first chapter itself. So based on the risk also we select many things. So risk analysis report is also required. So based on that we have to design the test cases. again use cases, epics and user stories. So as I said, these means normally what you need to remember here is from the foundation level. So use cases, epics, user stories, all these terms will contain the requirement in different form. Which form they will contain, this I will explain you. Model of the system behavior. So the model will also come in the system testing level. So there will be a model, you will give the input, and finally you will get the output over there. So modeling of the system or the model of the system simulators will be considered in the system testing level. State diagrams. So once you press, what will happen next? So state diagram. So once the door is opened and before it is closed, what all events will happen? So if this event happens, the door will close. So like that the state diagrams will come under system testing. And system and user manual. So how we have to use the system. So that will also come under system testing. So these are the documents. System and software requirement specification, risk analysis report, any type of requirements, use cases, epics, user stories, models, model of the system behavior, state diagrams, and system and user manuals. Now I will tell you why I was repeating so many times whenever there is a word called business, you should relate it to this, because here you have these many requirements and it's really difficult to remember all these things. But if you see, there is a high level requirement related to acceptance testing. Don't by heart each of these things. For example, business process, there comes the business acceptance level. User or business requirement comes the business user acceptance level. Regulations, legal contract, and security standards. So standard and all those things will come under acceptance level. So before accepting, they will see that whether you have fulfilled this standard, regulations, or the contract related things in it or not. So this is acceptance level. Use cases and user stories, as I said, this contains the requirement. So obviously this is a requirement for all the levels, starting from the integration testing. And component testing level, we have a component requirement. System requirement, so the requirement of the complete system, obviously we need it. So this makes sense that it will come under acceptance testing. If you see some documentation related stuff, that will also come under acceptance testing, like system or user documentation. Again, risk analysis report is also useful here, and it is also useful in the system testing. Then, if you have to do some activities like backup, you want to restore something, data recovery procedure, disaster related procedure, something like that, non-functional requirements, operational documentation. Again, the word came documentation. So again, you relate it to acceptance testing. And what I was telling here is, like, if you have something deployment, installations, disaster recovery procedures, backup and restores, which happens at the higher level, just connect it to the acceptance level. Okay. Performance targets, so non-functional testing. So you must know now, by now, that performance analysis or performance testing is a non-functional testing. So you have a non-functional requirement, then you have a performance target at this level. And database packages. This one, like, if you need a database for your complete project or something like that, then that also will be considered at the acceptance testing level by the customer. So here main thing is few words you pick. For example, business, documentation, some standards like regulations and all those stuff, they will come under acceptance level. Other things are backup, restores, procedures, installations, some performance targets, all these things will also come under acceptance level. So I don't expect someone to by heart these things. Okay, so as an just an overview, at component level you have detailed design, code, data model, component specification. At the integration level you have software and system design, sequence diagram, interface and communication, use cases everywhere until the acceptance testing level, architecture, workflow, and external and internal interfaces, both, because they covered interfaces here. No, this means the internal interfaces, that's why they have not explicitly mentioned internal interfaces. So here they're focusing on external interfaces. देन SRS सॉफ्टवेयर रिक्वायरमेंट स्पेसिफिकेशन, रिस्क एनालिसिस रिपोर्ट बोथ प्लेसेस, सिस्टम लेवल, एक्सेप्टेंस लेवल, यूज केसेस ऑल थ्री प्लेसेस, एपिक्स एंड यूजर स्टोरी ओवर हियर, मॉडल ऑफ द सिस्टम, स्टेट डायग्राम्स एंड यूजर मैनुअल्स. दिस आई विल नॉट गो थ्रू अगेन. सो नाउ द ऑब्जेक्ट्स. सो वॉट ऑल थिंग्स वी कैन टेस्ट एट डिफरेंट लेवल्स. ओके, फर्स्ट वन, लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट वन. When we are at the component testing level, we can test the components, units, modules, code. Okay, so these all things almost mean the same, that the single unit in the software. Data structure. Okay, I will not go into deep what is data structure. So for example, just an example here, like if you have an array, then how the data is structured in that? What is the size of that array? So those details also you need it so that you can, or some variables and all those things, if they are there, then you have to also access it. So like data structure, it is first in, first out, last in, first out, what type of data it is there. So you have to evaluate based on that. Classes. Okay, so normally what we will have is you will have a class and you will have their members. So when you are at this level, you also have to test these things, whether all these members are accessible, not accessible, all the called functions can be called, not called, whether it is called by any function or it is only as a dead code, it is available here. So classes are also there. And database modules. So that is also like separate module. So in the case of SQL, you will have some one module called open connection or some run SQL statement. So this will be one module. So just testing that module. So like that. So component, unit, modules and codes, data structure, classes, and database module. So you have to remember it. But if you see one more thing, if you see this modules, so module is nothing but again one module they are talking about. So that also you can relate it to component testing. Moving to the next one, integration testing. Subsystems. Subsystem means what? So there is a big system. Inside that there will be subsystems available, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 systems. So one big system will be made up of many subsystems. So we need subsystems here so that we can check the interfaces. So by name only it is quite clear, subsystems, as we saw here in this example. Then not the database module but the complete database itself. So database is a systematic collection of data. Databases support storage and manipulation of data. Database makes data management easy. So for managing the data, if you need, so why we need the data? Again, for sending, means this data only will be transferred, right, from one module to the other module. So that's why the database. Infrastructure and interfaces. Obviously, we need the infrastructure or we need the interfaces between the two modules. Again, the APIs. So API is nothing but application programming interfaces, which is software intermediary that allows two applications to talk to each other. So in a very simple term, there are two components. Between that, we will have these APIs to communicate between these two things. So, and the microservices. So software architecture design pattern in which complex applications are composed of small independent processes communicating with each other. So there are small processors which will communicate with each other. Linguistic API. So as I said, this is application programming language. So in that language they will be communicating. These services are small, highly decoupled and focus on doing a small task. So just transferring some data from one module to the other module, just very very small tasks they will do, these APIs. Okay, so subsystems, database, infrastructure and interfaces, APIs. So I stands for interface. So if it is interface, obviously it is related to integration testing. Then the microservices. System level. So what all documents we will get, what all things we need to test. We need the complete application. It should also include hardware if required or the complete software system. So if it requires hardware, then we need that also. And we need the complete software system. We also need the operating system. So if it has a hardware where this software needs to be flashed, then there will be some operating system which will be required, the OS. Then the system under test. So whatever is the system which you want to test, so that will also be included here in the system testing. System configuration and configuration data. So for example, if you have a software, that software can be used in different regions, but you don't want all the features to be accessed in all the regions. Then what you do is you do the configuration, and by doing configuration you check that these features are enabled only in this region or and the disabled in other region. And that type of configuration related data, you need it in system testing level, so that when you are performing for North America region, you are testing that software for North America region, then you test only the software which is required, only the features which is required for that, and others are not available. So that's why at the software level. At the end, applications, hardware and software system, operating systems, system under test, system configuration and configuration data. When we come to acceptance testing, so we have all these things. Obviously, we need the system under test, the system which we want to test, we need it. So we have it at both level, the previous level and this level. Again, configuration, obviously, if someone wants to accept the data for North America, then based on that configuration, they should get only those features. So that's why this is also at acceptance level. Point is same, configuration data for same purpose. Again, it comes business process, so business, so related to this one. Again, something related to recovery, installation, maintenance, all those things will come under acceptance testing. So recovery system, hot sites, operational and maintenance, if some forms are required, some reports are required, existing and converted production data. So production data is also required at acceptance testing, acceptance level. So once you do the system testing, after that it will go for production, then they will also have some data available at the production level. So those data are required at acceptance testing level. So here you may have to just go through it once or twice so that you remember this point. But on a from the top view, if you see something like configuration, they are at both levels, business related stuff at only at acceptance level, something related to recovery, installation, maintenance, hot sites, and like this will be at the acceptance level only. So if you remember those three levels, whatever is left out is at this level. Okay, so yeah, what is business process and all those things were explained, that is not required. So these were the objects. We can skip it, I think. We can just go further. So what are the type of defects we find? So we will stop at this point once we cover the defects. So when you are at the component testing level, okay, you will find incorrect functionalities. So if there is a component in that, some if statement is not working or your code is not at all going to the else part, in that case, those type of incorrect functionalities can be found at this level. Data flow related problem. So as I said, so if else statement, why we use, so that the data will flow the way we want based on the logic, it will flow. But if it is not working as per the logic, or if it is not flowing as per the logic, then we will find it at component level itself. Data flow related problems. Again, it's related to the same point, incorrect code and logic. So if the code is not implemented the way it should be, that we can find it at this level. And if there are some logic which is not right, because we can have access to the code and the logic is not right, we can find that also. So these are the three type of problems or the defects which we can find at this level: incorrect functionality, data flow problems, incorrect code and logic. So we don't need to see it right now. Yeah, I will not go through this one. We will anyway see this in the fourth number chapter. Means what I mean to say here is that if like this no part is there, right, the code is written in a way that we see that only the data is flowing in this path, but whatever we do here, whatever temperature value we set, but if it is not at all flowing through this path, so such type of data flow issues we can find. Logical, so there is a logic problem over here, so we can find such logic related issues also. So that is what was mentioned here, the incorrect code and logic, data flow problems and incorrect functionalities. Moving further, so we have component integration testing. You remember the component testing, then comes the component integration testing. What we will find here? Incorrect data, right, missing data, or incorrect data encoding. Encoding means what? when this encoding will come into picture. So suppose you have two modules, and what you do is you send one data from one module to the other module. Then you see like WhatsApp. So you send the data, it is encrypted, and other places it is decrypted. So we are using the encrypted data for the communication. So we are transferring the data. So incorrect data, missing data, or incorrect data encoding. So data related issues we will find in the component integration testing level. For example, there is one module, there is another module. This module is sending data in char form, character form, but this module wants data in the integer form. There is a mismatch. This you can find it in the integration testing. Incorrect sequence or timing of interface calls. For example, there is a module which is running in every 100 millisecond, and there is another module which wants to fetch the data in every 10 millisecond. So this module may not get a that get data updated data in every 100 millisecond. After 10 millisecond only it will get one data, right? So this type of timing related issues we can find it. Interface mismatches. Mismatch means what? Suppose there is a function, there is another function. This function is expecting three values, or this module is sending three values, but this one is only accepting two values, right? So such type of interface mismatches also we can find it. Then failure in communication between component. So obviously this is a component integration testing. So what we can expect? There is a two component, there is a failure between the communication. So failure in communication between component, or unhandled or improperly handled communication failures between components. So these were the some of the defects. So it's the example is same. I will not go through it. Okay, last one is also there. If there are any incorrect assumptions made about the meaning, unit, or boundaries of the data being passed between components. So we already see, like if the module owner here and if the module owner here has assumed that the data will be in character form, and here the module owner is assuming that the data will be in integer form. Such type of assumptions we can find it out when we do this integration testing. So these were the examples. So incorrect data, missing data, and incorrect data encoding, incorrect sequencing or timing related issues, interface mismatches, communication failure, or any other type of assumptions. System testing. Consistent message structure between the system. Okay, so when we are at the integration level, system integration level, okay, this is not system testing, sorry, this is system integration testing. So here what we will expect? The message is transmitted between two systems, and their consistencies we can check. Incorrect data, missing data, and incorrect data encoding. This can happen between two system also. Again, we will have an interface mismatch, failure between the communication, failure in communication between the systems, unhandled or improperly handled communication failure between systems. So same points, only here system, there it was component. So last one is again incorrect assumptions if we make. Sorry, this is the last one. Failure to comply with mandatory security regulations. So yeah, when we are at system level, we can see that if some security related bugs also we can find it out, because we are able to access the interfaces, right? So we can introduce the bug into the software also. When we go at system level, incorrect calculation. How? Because we will have a complete system, as I said. Suppose this is a calculator, we just want to add something. So if we are adding 6 and 4 from the output, from the input, and at the output we get 11, then it is the incorrect calculation. Such type of defects we can easily find it. Incorrect or unexpected system functional or non-functional behavior. So we can find the behavior of this system. So what it should, how it should behave? It should give the addition of these two number, but it is not behaving that way. When we are adding 6 plus 4, it is giving 10. So this is how we can find it out. Non-functional behavior. So we enter this data, after how much time we will get the result of it. Okay, so that is what. Incorrect control or data flow within the system. So data flow also we can find it. How? Again, same thing. Now we don't want what is the logic inside. When we are at component level, we bothered about the logic. Here we don't bothered about the logic, but we know that at this end, if we give the input, this end we should get the output. So end-to-end workflow we can see, matlab we can test it. So same example, if we give input, then whatever we are expecting, if we get it, that means the inside workflow is right. If we don't get, then there is something wrong in the workflow. Failure to properly and completely carry out end-to-end functional tasks. So this is what I was trying to explain. So end-to-end task. In the input, we give two inputs, and at the output, we want the addition, we don't get it. So end-to-end functionality, we can check it. Then, failure of the system to work properly in the system environment. So we will provide the actual environment, and then we will see that whether the software is working in that environment or not. So this environment we saw right in the first example. So if we switch on and switch off, then whenever the light should glow, it is glowing or not, so that we can check it when we have the actual environment. Failure of the system to work as described in system and user manual. And also what we can check is whatever is described in the manual. So in the manual they will tell if you press these two buttons, then you should get this assignment, you get the addition of this output. By reading the manual, if we perform that, then we can say that such type of testing we can do it at system level. Acceptance testing. Okay, so here also it's not difficult. You have to remember the term business. System workflow do not meet businesses or user requirement. If you don't meet the business or this requirement, that type of defect you will find in acceptance testing. Next one, again business. Business rules are not implemented correctly. No problem. It is again acceptance testing. System does not satisfy contractual regulatory requirements. So I also told you this is the input for this. If you find defect in this, obviously it is part of the acceptance testing. Again, non-functional failures, because here we are talking about non-functional requirements. So such as security vulnerabilities, inadequate performance related issues also we can find during the acceptance testing. Again, as I said, installation, operation related stuff, it is there, right? Anything, any operation like installation, backup, disaster recovery management, anything, such type of defect you get it at the acceptance level testing. So improper operation on a supported platform. So such type of words or sentence, if you see, are related to the acceptance testing. Responsibilities. Okay, we stop at this point. Maybe we can see the responsibility and two topics and some questions in the next session based on chapter number 2. So I will send you one PDF now after this session. You can go through that. Any questions in any of the topic what we just saw till now? What 1 minute, I will just stop the recording.